Senator Miriam, Defensor Santiago is holding a press briefing right now. Let's listen in.
Nila, hindi yan spur of the moment. Kaya ang problema natin ay mukhang hindi masyadong masigasig ang prosecution. Parang they're working around certain issues. Dapat yan, meron kang outline. That's what I suggest to the prosecution, which I used to do when I was a trial judge. If I find that prosecution is a little slow in its efforts, I will say, counsel, let's move on. And then in chambers, I will call the lawyer and say, can you please make an outline of your questions so that you can proceed sequentially and logically?
Alleged being biased, can he be asked to inhibit?
Who will ask him? When we ask, when you use the word ask, in legal procedure, that means make a motion in court. So you mean defense? Will the defense file a motion to inhibit him? I doubt it very much. Eh, kung hindi siya na-inhibit, de galit na siya sa iyo, talo ka na. Yan ang magiging mangyayari dyan. Remember what a very wise justice of the Supreme Court of the United States said? I'm talking about Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes. The life of the law has not been logic. It has been experience. So that's why law is not a question of common sense. That's why law is a question of so-called technicalities, because these technicalities were found to be absolutely essential to the achievement of justice in the long histories running to centuries of the legal profession. So don't think too badly of technicalities. They are meant to protect justice. However, as I said, impeachment should not be a case where the triumph will belong to those who cite the most technicalities. I intend to shortcut these technicalities when they are cited.
Yeah. Brian po from UNTV. Ma'am, kung sakali yung sa pre-trial na sinasabi nyo, may iwasan na po ba na magkaroon ng surprise witness saka surprise evidence?
Dapat iwasan yun. You know, under the Due Process Clause of our Constitution, it is in effect prohibited to spring a surprise during trial. In fact, in law, we have so-called discovery procedures well before the trial when you can go to certain people and just bring the clerk of court, not the entire court, with you and take his testimony so that you'll know how he will respond, particularly if he is a hostile witness or a witness for the adversary. These are so-called discovery procedures precisely meant to deflect any attempt to surprise either side, since due process is defined as following the search for both justice and truth from each of the litigants. So, kung sorpresa mo ang kalaban mo, that's unfair surprise. You are not allowed to do that. You cannot spring a mystery witness just to hold your TV audience in suspense. You likely be reprimanded by the judge or even maybe cited for an ethical conduct. Wala yan. Dapat, in fact, I think I will ask the counsel, will you please submit to the court a list of all your witnesses, their names, and the substance of their testimony. Ano bang sasabihin nila?
Hi, ma'am. What are your thoughts po on the debate about the scope of Article 2? Like, the defense insists that Article 2 does not include allegations of ill-gotten wealth, but the prosecution says that was actually included in the discussion of the article.
Well, I'm not allowed to comment as a judge outside of the courtroom on the merits of the case. That will go to the merits of the case, and that will be decided by the High Court of Impeachment in caucus.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. This is the microphone.
Good morning. Going back to for senators, senator judges who might ask too many questions. So what should be done if they do that again? If they ask more than 2-3 questions or become acting as prosecutors?
Well, this is a very unique procedure, as I said. There is no approximate procedure in our entire government like this. And therefore, unlike a regular court of justice, where the presiding officer, who is also the judge, can reprimand people and tell them what to do or make or halt them in their tracks, the presiding officer has no such power. He's only one of the 23 senator judges. So I would, if I were in the shoes of the presiding officer, I would simply call a recess. I'd call a judicial recess, and then I would give a gentle reminder to the senator that there are time limits.
Ma'am, in the past week, do you think some senators went overboard with their kind of questioning?
I think everybody tended to go overboard. First, because they thought that they had to take a dramatic stance in front of the TV cameras. That is a problem with TV. Because of the principle, the presence of the observer changes the observed. You know, if you shut down all the TV cameras, this proceeding would be finished in 1 week. That is, it's be a big, big problem with which the U.S. courts have been wrestling. So we'll have to input that now. What is the effect of television on the quickness with which litigation is conducted? We all want to finish because of the principle, justice delayed is justice denied. But people want more than 15 seconds of fame. They want to stand there and say abstruse legal terms that nobody uses anymore. By the way, in the legal profession, it is completely outdated to use Latin terms. You use esoteric terms like here in above, where in before. That's no longer allowed. When they say that, that means that they are not okurang, they are not in step with the latest movements in the legal profession. Everything must be intelligible to the layman because the people watching, the litigants, are lay people. That is why they tend to overact, because in actual trial court, when a lawyer appears, he is paid an appearance fee. And therefore, the client expects, if I pay you $10,000 today, show me $10,000 worth of histrionics or your acting prowess. So they fling their arms about and they speak in their squeaky voices. So, that is why they do that, because they have to earn their appearance fee. It is sometimes an effect of the billing system. If we do not pay our lawyers periodically, but on a per appearance basis, that's what will happen. Nakakahiya naman sa kliyente niya, tumanggap na siya ng pera, binulsan niya, kaya dapat naman marami naman din siyang pag-anon-ganon. At saka, that goes to both sides. That's the problem.
Yeah, see.
Ma'am, defense panel na dumulog sa Korte Suprema, kung nila nagugustuhan na nagiging ruling ng impeachment court?
Well, as I said already, in my very humble view, that is not a remedy available, because this is a high court of impeachment. We're not a minor court. We're a high court. We're as high as the Supreme Court, because we are a constitutional creation. And we are not listed among those over which the Supreme Court has jurisdiction. There's a constitutional list on areas or topics on which the Supreme Court has jurisdiction. We're not listed there. In fact, in the rules of court, there is a specific exceptional rule that says these rules of court shall not apply to certain cases like land registration cases, naturalization cases, election cases, etc. So that means that the rules of court do not necessarily apply to all kinds of litigation, so even much less so in an impeachment court. The Supreme Court cannot assert any level of judicial authority over the impeachment court. We are completely separate and independent.
Ma'am, one more question. Do you agree with the statement of Senator Enrile that the impeachment trial is akin to a criminal trial?
Well, it has, as I said, the word there is quasi. Quasi, almost, but not exactly the same. So it has, you know, certain criminal features. And I will say something that might surprise you. Look at the Constitution. It says that if the person is convicted, the sentence shall go no further than removal from office and disqualification from public office. That means that we can go less than removal from office. That will surprise even the senators. Maybe I should say it during one of our caucuses. Look at the way it is worded. It shall go no further than. Meaning to say, hindi ka pwedeng lumampas. Hindi mo pwedeng taasan pa. Hanggang ka lang sa removal from office and disqualification from public office. So you can just mete out the punishment of, let us say, reprimand or censure. Pwede rin yung ganun. that should make everybody think. We don't necessarily have to either convict or acquit. We can also reprimand. We can also just censure, as long as it's not more than, as long as you not put him to death, because that would be capital punishment. Yes?
Ma'am Florante from DCRH. Marami po nagsasuggest na dapat ni Wikang Pilipino gagamitin sa impeachment court. Pero may mga technical terms and mga legal jargons na hindi natin pwedeng isalin kaagad-agad sa Tagalog, di ba?
Ganito,
anong suggestion niyo po?
We can answer that problem like this. Before the presentation of every witness, the person presenting him at this stage, the prosecutor, should be asked to explain, anong balak mo ipakita, patunay sa pamagitan nitong testigo na ito? What is the gist of his testimony? Para maintindihan natin. Kaya, dapat yan, bago mag-umpisa ang examination ng isang testigo, dapat sabihin na ng abogado niya, anong pakay ko dito? Anong sinusubukan ko gagawin? Anong inambisyon ko dito? In Tagalog. Para maintindihan ng mga nanonood, has he succeeded in proving his point? Then we go on to the next point. And that should be the point on which the counsel from the adverse party will base his cross-examination. In other words, really, the success of litigation depends on preparation. If you're not prepared, then you're going on a fishing expedition. And by the way, intend to object if anyone goes on a fishing expedition during examination of a witness, whether direct or indirect. Dapat alam mo kung saan ka pumupunta, hindi na paikot-ikot ka. You're wasting my time. And it makes the senators lose interest, particularly those who are not lawyers. We are not confining this process to those with technical legal knowledge. Otherwise, we'll have no public participation. We may as well hold it in a darkened room, just among us, ourselves. We want the public to understand what's going on. Kaya kailangan, I'm going to suggest, I've suggested to the Senate President, minsan man lang sa isang linggo, magpaliwanag ang presiding officer. Ngayong linggo, ang mangyayari ay ipresenta itong testigo X, Y, and C ng prosecution dahil hangad nila na ipatunay na ganito, ganyan, ganyan. Tapos, bawat naman magpresenta ng testigo, ito namang testigo, ang aming susubukan na ipatunay na ganito yon. Kaya ipaliwanag natin.
Nimpa. Nimfa po sa DZBB. Ma'am, sabi niyo po kanina, you suffered from terminal boredom last week. Saan point po kayo na bore? And from now on, do you intend to bore yourself more and every day?
This is a duty, believe me. I would really rather, you know, go scuba diving in the Bermuda Triangle and get possibly lost there. Believe you me. It really will raise my blood pressure. But in any event, I have come because this is my duty as a senator. I have no choice. Point of terminal boredom, citation from Justice Story, who is one of the famous legal authors. Whatever he said no longer applies. Justice Story lived centuries ago. Why cite him in this 21st century? So that is the problem sometimes with law, when people quote at random from the past without connecting it to the present circumstances. Well, anyway, the moment he said that, I just turned it off. I said my act of contrition, got down on my knees, and almost shot myself.
Yeah, Myla, please.
Ma'am, how do you describe the performance of the prosecution last week, or if you want to describe also the defense team?
Well, they were all a little bit nervous. That is to be expected. And I think they had a little fear of the unknown, because they did not know how things were going to go, how the media would treat them. And I think now that more or less they've gotten into the swing of things, especially if our rulings as a high court of impeachment are consistent, then I think maybe we can have a more disciplined structure. I would just say it was pretty unstructured for the first week. You know, these hotshot lawyers, when they appear before a judge, they're very, very prepared. That's why they deserve their reputations.
Ma'am, going back lang dun, ma'am, sa opinion niyo tungkol sa Supreme Court, kasi the Senate is expected to file its answer on the TRO or move to stop the impeachment. So if the Senate decides to to answer that, ma'am, anong implication nun? Ibig ba sabihin we will the Senate will be under the jurisdiction of the Senate now?
You're correct. The Supreme Court. Point. Does it imply anything? That is imply submission to jurisdiction? Well, there is a rule in civil cases in the rules of court that if a person alleges the court has no jurisdiction, still he must appear and allege, make his allegation. Otherwise, he will be defaulted. He will be declared in default, and the other party will automatically win. So, if we apply this example in civil cases to the impeachment court, if at all the impeachment court will file a reply, it is simply to say, you have no jurisdiction over us, and we do not care to explicate or to explain ourselves fully at length, because there is no necessity. We're an independent court. Out of courtesy to you, we just answer to educate you that you have no power over us. That should be the extent of the answer. And we'll proceed anyway, no matter what they do. And the Senate, in effect, could say to the Supreme Court, all right, you want us to answer? We don't want to answer. And who is now going to take action against us? You and what army?
Would you know, ma'am, kung yun ang magiging sagot ngayon ng Senate?
I will suggest that. I just remembered now. There's a similar situation envisioned in the rules on civil cases. If you think that the court has no jurisdiction, you cannot just keep quiet and say, I'll just ignore them. Then they will proclaim a decision where your opponent, you are declared, for example, to use a legal term, non-suited. You did not go to litigation or you lost by default. So the decision will go to your opponent. That's why the civil court rule involved is that you must appear, make an appearance, just to tell the court you have no jurisdiction. Then you litigate over whether you are correct or not. So that will be, in effect, the form that the Senate answer will be. I should not even call it the Senate, that the High Court answer will be to the Supreme Court. You might be supreme, but we are high.
Ma'am, ano mo sasabi mo kay Senator Indrile bilang presiding officer po?
Oh, he is very, very conscientious. He has a problem with his eyes, but I can tell that he's been reading a lot. So that must be very taxing for him. And so far, all his rulings have been respectable. There's no question to doubt their competence. Yes?
Ma'am, considering yung naging facing ng trial last week, sa tingin mo gaano tatagal itong trial?
Well, I'll clear that up this afternoon at 2 o'clock. I'll ask, how many lawyers are you going to present? Approximately, of course, because it depends on what points come up. But still, we already know that. Ngayon, ilan ang testigo mo? Ilang testigo ng defense counsel? O di makompute natin. Pagkatapos ng trial na yan, first the prosecution presents evidence and then the defense presents evidence. Meron pa yan. Meron na tawag na rebuttal when the prosecution, defense, prosecution again. That is called rebuttal. Kung merong pinresentang defensa na hindi na foresee ng prosecution, they have a right to rebuttal, meaning to say they can present a few witnesses to rebut what the defense said, followed by sir rebuttal. The defense naman ngayon will try and controvert what they say in rebuttal. So that should be prosecution, defense, rebuttal, sir rebuttal. And so within all of these terms, the two sides this afternoon will have to tell me how many witnesses do they expect. Ayoko nang sagot na, well, it depends, Your Honor. Malamang sa... I will, of course, say, you're, of course, not bound by what you're saying. We're only asking for a ballpark figure.
Okay. Yeah, perhaps Last two questions.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, before po nung impeachment trial, meron na kayong statements somehow defending the Chief Justice. So, ma'am,
yeah, before the case was filed here, yes, because ma'am. I was being asked as a politician, and you know that the media will stab me in bold daylight if I say no comment. So, of course, I had to answer. But you'll notice that after the articles of impeachment had been officially filed with us, I've tried not to say anything concerning the merits of the case. So it should be taken as off the record of the impeachment court. Many of us in politics answered according to our own independent analysis. Oh, yes, yes.
Pwedeng sabihin na may leaning kayo kay Chief Justice Corona?
Oh, that is only a layman's opinion. But now I'm hearing the evidence. Noon, wala akong ebidensya. So of course, I was only answering on the basis of general principles of law. I'm a political science major, so I was just quoting what I learned in poli-sci. I think that these are the general sentiments of the legal profession. But now, you'll have to be bound, not by those things that I read in the textbooks, but by the actual evidence. We are bound by evidence. That's all we can do. Okay?
Okay, thank you very much.
Welcome.
Maraming salamat po.
According to her tweet, she is ready to rumble. Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago is expected to attend the impeachment trial today, the first time she's going to do that after being on leave for hypertension, although she jokingly did say that she suffered from terminal boredom from monitoring the trial last week. Senator Santiago gave a briefing on how she'll be handling procedures as a senator judge and also gave her opinion on how the prosecution and the defense and also the Senate, how the Senate did as an impeachment court last week. Okay, stay tuned for ANC special coverage, Chief Justice on Trial, beginning at 1 this afternoon. Keep it here. Dateline Philippines comes your way at